Welcome back. This lesson is on developing SLOs from competences. Now, this actually is supposed to be done as a hands-on activity, but since that will not be possible, I will only share some broad suggestions on how to go about this process. Those of you who have already received instruction in medical education technology would probably be able to do this, especially those who have completed the Curriculum Implementation Support Program or CISP. So, the first thing that you need to do is to determine the domain that you're dealing with. Is it the cognitive domain? Is it the affective domain? Or is it the psychomotor domain? And within the domain, what level is the competency targeting? So, once you know that, then you have to look at the level of the learners. So, this could be either in terms of the phase, so phase 1, phase 2, or semester 1, 2, 3, and so on, or first year, second year, etc. You also need to determine if there are sub-competencies or milestones for that given competency. So, when you have gone through the exercise of looking at the competencies which are relevant to your particular subject, you would obviously identify some competencies which cannot be addressed immediately. You need to break it up, and therefore you will have sub-competencies or milestones. So you may achieve some of these in first year, some in the second year, and some later. So you need to know whether there are milestones for the given competency that you are trying to address. And if there are milestones, you need to know what has already been accomplished, which milestones have been achieved, if any. You also need to know the time as well as the resource available for your session, and you need to know the number of learners. Once you have all this information, then you can identify an appropriate teaching learning method and you can determine which milestone or competency can be achieved. So usually what happens is that when you have identified these things, you will be able to figure out whether you can address multiple competencies which target the same domain or the same level within the same domain in a single session. So you sort out whether they are addressing the cognitive, affective, or the psychomotor domain, and if you have multiple competencies within the cognitive domain that can be covered in a single session, then you try to address them. And you will formulate educational objectives for the session based on the things that we have just discussed. And you must remember to identify how assessment will be conducted at the end of it. So do not forget that assessment also depends on the objectives. So you are working in reverse. You are starting with competences and you are identifying the domain, the level, you're then looking at various other resources which may be available to you, and based on that you formulate educational objectives. And you must remember that the educational objectives are linked to the teaching learning method as well as the assessment. So that's basically what I have reinforced here. That's about developing SLOs from competencies. So see you in the next.